In the last video, we have seen the small signal operation, that is IRI model. Today we are going to start the hybrid pi model. Also, you know what is the hybrid? This hybrid pi is nothing but represented by a resistance whose value is R pi, and that is seen from the base end. So this is the hybrid pi model, small signal operation of BJT. You see, this is the base terminal, this is collector, this is emitter terminal. And across after the base, a resistor is connected between base and emitter. That value is nothing but R pi. Okay, and this is a voltage controlled current source, which is it is a current source which is controlled by this voltage VB between base and emitter. Okay, so we can there are two type of representation equivalent circuit model. One is voltage controlled current source, or second one, it is a current controlled current source, meaning it is a current source which is controlled by another current source, which is nothing but IB. Okay, we have already seen these two type of configuration before. Now this model represents the BJT as a voltage control voltage source and explicitly include the input resistance looking into the base, that is RPi. We have already seen before what is the RPi. It is the equivalent small signal resistance seen from base end, that resistance in between base and emitter. This model yield, okay, for this model what do we have to find? First we will see the VB value, and from this VB value we can easily find this GMVB, which is GM value is nothing but IC upon VT, and our RPi value, this RPi is nothing but beta upon GM. A beta value is given for a particular circuit model, beta value is given, and from this equation you find the value of GM, and beta by GM will give me RPi value. Okay, so the IC is nothing but GM VBE, and our IB, which is nothing but VBE upon RPi. We have already seen these two expressions before. So this model also yield a current expression for IE. We know our IE, that is emitter current, which is nothing but VB upon RPi. Our VB upon RPi means this is the IB plus GMVB. There are two currents that are coming. Emitter current is nothing but one is this current, one is this current. This current is nothing but GMVB. The collector current is nothing but GMVB. And the base current, that IB, which is nothing but VB upon RPi. So these two currents constitute our emitter current. Okay, so what I did, now I took the common VB upon RPi. So it will remain 1 over here. And VB taken common out, so it will remain GM VPi. So VB upon RPi, 1 plus GM RPi. Now you tell me, what is GM into RPi? Is nothing but our beta. So in place of that, I wrote 1 plus beta. Now, if I will take this 1 plus beta into denominator, it will become VBE upon RPi whole divided by 1 plus beta. The numerator 1 plus beta is taken as a denominator. Now you tell me, we have already seen the relation between RPi and RE. That R pi is nothing but Re times 1 plus beta. We have seen before. From here you can see we have already derived this expression. R pi is nothing but beta plus 1 Re. So our R pi upon beta plus 1 is nothing but our Re. So that's why I replace R pi upon 1 plus beta is nothing but Re. Okay. So in this is for the first diagram. For the second diagram also, it is a current control current source. It means it is a current source whose current is IC, that is controlled by IB. So here our GM VBE, okay, this is GM VBE for this circuit diagram. So in place of VBE, what I can write? The VBE is nothing but the voltage drop between this RPi, which is nothing but IB times RPi. Current into resistance will give me the voltage drop. So that's why in place of VBE, what I wrote? IM IB times RPi. Now this GM into RPi, they will multiply it, and what will they will give me? They will give me a value beta, because we know GM into RPi is nothing but a beta. So our GM VBE can also be represented as beta, and this is IB, beta IB. So the in place of GM VBE, I can replace a current control current source whose value is beta IB. Okay, so this is the hybrid pi model. And in the last video we have seen the RE model, that the resistance between base and emitter, that is seen from this emitter side, that is RE. Similar to this small signal operation that is applied to the NPN transistor, we can apply for our PNP transistor also. In the same manner, there will be no change in this PNP type of transistor. Okay, but because in our everywhere in our circuit, we are always using NPN transistor. That's why we are reading NPN transistor much closer as compared to PNP transistor, because there is very slightly change in between NP and PNP. But there are some like sign changes, like VCE will be replaced by VEC, VBE will be replaced by VEB, like that, and the direction of current will also change. Now we'll see the application of a small signal equivalent circuit model, that is in a numerical how a small signal operation can be done. So there are certain steps The availability of the small signal BJT circuit model makes the analysis of the transistor application circuit a systematic process. Means this application will show me how systematic you can approach to a numerical or a particular application to solve any type of numerical. So there are how many steps are there? There are basically 5 steps. The process consists of following steps. So what are those steps? The first step is nothing but eliminate the signal source and determine the DC operating point of the BJT, in particular the DC collector current IC. It means in a given circuit, your both AC and DC, both components are there. So first step, what you have to do? You have to remove the AC component. Only you have to take the DC values, and from those DC values, you have to find the Q point values. Means nothing but the IC. Basically, I have to find the value of IC. Okay. That is the first step. In the second step, what you have to find? After finding the IC, you have to find the value of GM, which is nothing but IC upon VT. You have to find RPi. RPi is nothing but beta upon GM. In the first step we found the value of IC, and in the second step we found the value of GM, and from GM beta is given in your question. From there you will get RPi, and once you came to know about RPi and you know beta, we know this relationship. RPi is nothing but beta plus 1 RE. So from here you can find the value of RE. Okay, that is the second step. So in the third step, you have to eliminate the DC sources by replacing each DC source with a short circuit. If a DC voltage source is there, we will make it short circuit. If a DC current source is there, we will make it open circuit. That is the third step. We will remove the DC values. Then replace the BJT with one of its small signal equivalent, that is either hybrid pi model or RE model. You know both models, you have seen just before. This is one hybrid pi model. So you can replace with any of these, either this one or this one. Okay. After replacing, okay. So according to our convenient, you have to use. Means since there are two equivalent model, one is GM in terms of GMVB, one is in terms of IB. That is for hybrid pi model. And second one also RE model is also there. So according to our convenient, you can take any circuit model and you apply that equation. Now analyze the resulting circuit to determine the required quantities. That is voltage gain or input resistance. What is asked in the question, we will find those. So what are the 5 steps? We will see those 5 steps applying to a numerical. I have already solved that numerical to save your time. Let me show you that one. So this is a question. It is given, we wish to analyze the transistor amplifier to determine the voltage gain Vout upon V input. You see, these are nothing but my small signal gain Vout upon V in. Assume in the question it is given beta is 100, and this is the circuit symbol, this is the equivalent this is the circuit model given. You see, this is the AC values, small signal model. This is the DC value is given. Here also VCC DC value. Here the output which is taken AC value plus DC value. Okay, so according to our steps, the 5 steps that we read just before, we have to proceed. So what is the first step? Our first step is to, we have to eliminate the signal source, means AC signal source should be eliminated. And we have to determine the DC value and basically the collector current. So you see, I have done in the same way. Determine the quotient operating point. Assume V input 0. That is, we will make our AC value will equal to 0. Then we will find, we have to find IC. But for finding IC, we have to find our IB. So what is IB? This is the step 1. This is for the step 1. This is in the question. This is for the step 1. Means this is a DC biasing. Okay. So I replace all the signal source by short circuit. There are no AC signal are there. So you see, this is a VBB whose value is 3 volt, and the base resistor is connected to the positive terminal of battery. That's why I have connected a positive terminal battery plus 3 volt. Then this is RBB, which is nothing but given 100 kilo ohm. And we will write the equation for the IB. So what will our IB? IB is nothing but this voltage minus this voltage drop divided by this resistance. So that value is nothing but 3 volt minus 0.7 volt divided by 100 kilo ohm. I will get 0.0323 milliampere. This is my IB. Now, what I have to find? I have to find IC. Our IC is nothing but beta IB. So our beta IB is nothing but beta. In the question, it is given 100. So 100 times 0.023 milliampere is nothing but 2.3 milliampere. Okay. In the step 1, it is written, we have to find the Q point across the operating points. Operating point means IC and VCE also, or VCC also. So for that, I have to find the value of this VC. This is capital V, capital C. Okay. So what will be our VC? Our VC is nothing but VCC minus ICRC. And we have already known the value of IC. So I will write VCC minus ICRC. VCC is nothing but 10 volt. IC value 2.3 milliampere. RC is nothing but 3 kilo ohm. If we will put all these values, you will get a VC value. That is the collector voltage. Voltage between collector and ground. That is nothing but 3.1 volt. Okay. Now we have to see in which region our transistor is operating. The voltage that we got at VC. At this VC, what is the voltage? Which is nothing but 3.1 volt. And what is the voltage over here? This is nothing but 0.7 between base and emitter. Let me show you that one. So this is a transistor, and across the base and emitter junction, VBE, which is nothing but 0.7 volt. And here you see in this question, this emitter is grounded. It means emitter is grounded means my VE, which is nothing but 0 volt. So my VBE, which is nothing but VB minus VE, is also VB because this VE is equal to 0. So my VBE, which is equal to VB, that is equal to 0.7 volt. So what I found, our VB value is 0.7 volt. And the value of VC that we found is nothing but 3.1 volt. So VC is nothing but 3.1 volt. So how we can check that our transistor is operating in which region? We have to see the collector base junction. If collector base junction is in reverse bias or it is in forward bias, we will see. If it will be in forward bias, then it might be in saturation region. If it is in reverse bias, then there might be two conditions. One is either cutoff, one is linear. Now, how to check cutoff and linear? We have to again check our emitter base junction. If our emitter base junction is forward bias and collector base junction is reverse bias, then it is in active region. If collector base junction is reverse bias and also emitter base junction is reverse bias, then it is in cutoff region. Okay, for this case, our VBE, which is nothing but base emitter junction, that is in forward bias, that is positive voltage is there, forward bias, and our collector base junction is reverse bias, it means it is in active region. So that's why we have written that our transistor, after finding the question condition, our transistor will be operating in the active region, because we have already seen the base emitter junction is forward bias and the voltage VBC. If we will find the VCB, our VCB value should be greater than or equal to minus 0.4. But our here VC value is nothing but 3.1. Our VB value that we got equal to 0.7. This value will give me 2.4. 2.4 equal to minus 0.4. Then it is in active region. It means it is satisfying the condition. So now our transistor is operating in the active region. That is the for the step 1. Now tell me, what is the step 2? We have to find the value of GM, R pi, RE. So you see, if I found the value of RE, R pi, and RE, GM into R pi. What is RE? That is the emitter resistor seen from the emitter side. That is VT upon IE value. This is the formula for RE. You know the value of VT for room temperature. If it is not given in the question, you will take 25 millivolt. What is IE? Our IE is nothing but IC upon alpha. Or in terms of IB, what I can write? Our IE is nothing but beta plus 1 times IB. You know the value of beta, so you know the value of IB. So you can easily find this IE. There are two formula for IE. One is IC upon alpha, and second one is nothing but our beta plus 1 times IB. So you will get the value of RE. Okay. Also, you will get the value of GM. GM is nothing but IC upon VT. You know the value of VT. You know value of IC. You can get GM. Then you will find R pi. R pi is nothing but beta upon GM. In the question, beta value is given 100. GM value that we found from here is nothing but 92 milliampere per volt. Because this is transconductance, means ampere per volt, current per voltage. That is R pi is nothing but 1.09 kilo ohm. So our step 2, that we found all the three values. Now, step 3, eliminate the DC sources by replacing short circuit. If a DC voltage is there, we will make it short circuit. That is for the step 3, replace the VBB and VCC with short circuit. So this is the circuit diagram for the step 3 and step 4 also. That is, we will replace this VBB and this VBC into short circuit. Means it is grounded. You see, this is grounded, and after the in AC signal, that is grounded. There is no DC values are there. Then at what is the step 4? We will replace the BJT with any of its small equivalent model. So here I have taken the pi model. So this is the circuit diagram. What I did, I applied the pi model. What is that pi model? That the BJT will be replaced by a pi like this. This is R pi, a resistor would be there, and there is a current source whose value is nothing but GMVB. and before the base a RBB and VI is connected. You see, before the base a RBB and VI is connected. After the output, that is VC, a RC and ground is connected. And after the collector, C, collector terminal, VC, that is a RC and ground is connected. Okay, so this part and this part was already there before. You see, this part and this part is already there. I just replaced the BJT with its pi model. So this is the pi model, that is a R pi and a volt current source GMVB. Now you see, this is a voltage source and there are two resistors. The main thing is that I have to find output. My output voltage is nothing but the voltage drop across RC, that is the current multiplied by this resistance. And this current is nothing but GMVB, because there is no other current, only this current is flowing through this. So this GMVB, and finding this current, I have to find the VB, and our VB is nothing but the voltage drop across R pi. That's why I am starting from here. Okay, so our VBE, that is voltage drop across this R pi, is nothing but supply voltage multiplied by this resistance divided by sum of this resistance. So VI R pi upon R pi plus RB. So you know the value of R pi, you know value of RBB. So you will find our VBE, which is in terms of VI. This is 0.11 VI. Once I will find this value of VBE, then I will find this value of current, which is nothing but GMVB. So my GMVBE will be equal to GM value that I found, 92 milliampere per volt, multiplied by 0.011 VB, that is our GMVB. This GMVB current is flowing across the resistor, so across the resistor RC. So what will be the voltage drop across this resistor RC, which is nothing but V out, that is equal to GMVBE RC. So that is minus GMVBE RC. Why minus? This current that is flowing across this resistor, ground to bottom, and I am taking bottom to ground. That's why the change in the means voltage, which is nothing but minus GMVB RC. Okay, if I write a loop equation, let me show you that one. Across this resistor RC, a current whose value is GMVBE that is flowing, and I have to find the value of V output. Now if I write a loop like this, then you see, I will move from negative to positive, means I will write plus V naught. Then I am moving from top to bottom, but my current direction is bottom to top. You see, this is the current direction and this is my direction, and my direction and current direction both are opposite. That's why I am writing a positive voltage across a resistor, which is nothing but VBE GMRC. And if my direction and the current direction both are same direction, then I will write a negative voltage drop across a resistor. Okay, hope this point is clear. So our V output is nothing but minus RC GMVBE. That I wrote, minus AB is nothing but minus GMVBE RC. You will put all these values, you will get our V output, that is in terms of V input. Okay, so my gain, that will be V out upon V input, is nothing but minus 3.4 volt per volt. So for solving this type of question, these are the 5 steps that you have to follow. Okay, when a small signal model is given or for small signal model is asked. Now we will see how we can solve directly, means without using these 5 steps, we can solve any numericals directly from the figure. So means it is for the experiencer, the circuit model for our practical purposes. We don't have that much time to find all these 5 steps, so we can directly move from our step 1 to step 5 through like this. So you see, the first step, that is you have to find the value of R pi. So if this is a NPN transistor, from this NPN transistor I can find the all small signal model or at the last gain by this direct method. First one is you have to find the value of R pi. Then the second value, you have to find the value of IB. Our IB is nothing but VI upon this RBB with a series connection of R pi. That's why the base current, which is nothing but voltage upon equivalent resistance. And this equivalent resistance is nothing but RBB and a series connection of R pi. Once you will find the value of IB, you can easily find the value of third part, that is IC. Or IC is nothing but beta times IB. Okay, and once you will find the value of IC, then you can find our V output. So what will be the V output, which is nothing but IC RC, because there is no VCC term is there. Whatever is the drop across this voltage output is nothing but minus IC RC. That is minus ICRC. Okay, and in place of IC, what you can write? Beta IB. In place of IB, what you can write? VI times RBB plus R pi. So that's why I put all those values. My V output, which is nothing but minus beta RC upon RBB plus R pi times V input. So what will be my gain? My gain is nothing but V out upon V input, which is nothing but minus beta RC upon RBV plus R pi. By using direct method, you can easily find the value of AB. Okay, so my AB is nothing but V out upon V input, which is nothing but minus beta RC upon RBV plus R pi. In the question, RC value is given, beta value is given, RB value is given. Only if you know the value of R pi, then you can easily find all these values. Okay. Now, this is for NPN transistor. So let's see how to apply for a PNP transistor. Same thing. For a PNP transistor, you see PNP means pointing in. It is pointing in. So here the emitter, resistor, and this is the input applied across the emitter, and output is taken across the collector. Here base is the common. Now, the first step that you have to find the value of RE, that is small signal resistance between base and emitter, that is seen from the emitter side. That is RE. Once you will find the value of RE, you can easily find the value of IE. IE is nothing but V input upon RE. So this is the voltage, this is the resistance. Then what will be the current? It is nothing but this voltage upon this resistance. So this is VI, V input upon RE. The third step that you have to find IC, which is nothing but alpha IE. Because in a question you know value of beta, or easily you can find the value of alpha, you know from beta, or in the question it is given value of alpha. So that's why you can find the value of IC, which is nothing but alpha by V RE into V input. Once you'll find the value of IC, then you can easily find this V output. The V output across the collector and ground is nothing but the voltage drop across this RC, which is nothing but IC RC. You know the value of IC is nothing but alpha by RE into V input and RC that is given. So from there you can get the output gain. V output upon V input is nothing but alpha RC upon RE. Okay, you remember these two formula, it will become easy for you to solve the gain for a PNP transistor or for a NPN transistor. Next we will see what will be the effect of early effect, means the effect of VCE in our small signal analysis. So we know in early effect our collector current that depend upon VBE and VCE. When there is no early effect, our IC depend upon only VBE. By the equation, IC is nothing but IS e power, let me write that equation. So when there is no early effect, our IC, instantaneous current, both AC and DC are added, which is nothing but IS e power VBE upon VT. And when early effect will be there, then there is a multiplier term of VCE upon VA. This term will be multiplied with this one. Okay, so in early effect, this VCE and VBE both depend upon IC, means our IC depend upon both VBE and VCE. So that is written in early effect, our IC depend upon VBE and VCE. This dependency on VCE can be modeled by assigning a finite output resistance. So how we can, we have already seen in the early effect chapter that our this early effect, this voltage upon this current can be measured with a resistor whose value is R0, and that is connected at the output side. So that's why it is written it can be modeled by assigning a finite output resistor to the control out source in the hybrid pi model. So you see, if I omit this R0, it is a hybrid pi model or not? Base, and there is a R pi resistor, and there is a GM V pi. That is, V pi is nothing but our VBE, that is GM VBE. So if I will add R0, means it is the early effect is added over here. Similarly, you see this is a current control current source, R pi, this is beta IB, and this current source depend upon this IB current. And if I will add the early effect, then this R0 will come into picture. So this is the hybrid pi model signal with R0, means early effect is added. So what is the value of R0, which is nothing but VA upon IC dash. This is the early voltage. This is the collector current when there is no early effect, means only this term, IC equal to IS e power VB upon VT. I can write IC dash, or I can easily mention it IC. Okay, so this is nothing but collector current when there is no early effect. So our output resistor, whose value is nothing but early voltage upon this collector current, without early effect collector current. Okay. And here our VB, V pi, which is nothing but our VBE. So you see, this IC dash and IC both are equal. That is IS e power VB upon VT. There is no early effect in this case. And when RO is added, then will be there will be early effect. So R0 will be in parallel with RC in the circuit. You see, the R0 is connected across the parallel connection. So what will be our output? Our output is nothing but GM VBE the current multiplied by there is a resistor across. This is only for the hybrid by equivalent model. If I will connect a RC, that RC will be in parallel with that, then the current across the collector means across the output, what will be the voltage drop is nothing but GM V pi times the parallel connection of RC and R0. Okay, here I have not shown the RC, but if I will connect a RC over here, then the parallel connection of these two multiplied by this current will give me the output voltages. So my output voltage, which is nothing but GM V pi, GM V pi or GM V B, both are same. Since I am showing pi model, that's why I replaced my VBE by V pi. Okay. But you see, in this case, my gain will be reduced. Why? Before it was only GM, VBE, RC. As this R0 came into picture, this parallel connection value will decrease. As this parallel connection will decrease, this my V output will also decrease. But if my R0 is very greater than RC, then the reduction in gain can be negligible. It means, if I will take my output, now my output which is nothing but V output, which is nothing but minus GM VBE RC parallel R0. Before it was minus GM VBE RC. It was the output before. Now as this early effect came into picture, the parallel connection occurred. Now you see, let's take our RC value is equal to 2 kilo ohm. Our R0 let's take 4 kilo ohm. Okay. Now you tell me, what will be the gain? The gain is nothing but the parallel connection of these two. This parallel of these two is nothing but 2 cross 4 by 2 plus 4. So 8 by 6. 8 by 6 means this value will become 1.3. Means before it was only minus GM VBE. Let's take this minus GM VBE value 10. And before it was 10 into RC value was 2. Before it was 20, whatever the unit. Voltage, 20 voltage. This is 20 voltage before, when only GM, VBE, RC was there. As this RC parallel R0 came into picture, this parallel connection gives me value 1.3. Then this output will become minus 10 into 1.3, which is nothing but minus 13. So, it was the value minus 10. Minus GM, VBE value is nothing but 10, that is 1.2. So, you see, my gain decreased or not? Before the gain was 20, when was there was only RC. As this R0 came into picture, my gain decreased 13. But this gain can be maintained same if my R0 value is high. It means my R0 let's take 40. Then what it will become? The parallel connection of 2 and 40, it will become 2 cross 40 by 2 plus 40, which is nothing but 80 upon 42. So 80 upon 42, that is approximate to 2 or not, very close to 2. So what will be my output will become? It is nothing but minus, means 10 multiplied, that is approximate to 2. So that value will be nearly equal to 20. It means if my R0 value is very high, then the parallel connection will become only RC. The effect of R0 is negligible if that R0 value is very high. So what is the minimum condition? If our R0 value is 10 times RC, then this effect of R0 in the output or in the gain can be minimized. Okay, now at the last we will see the three type of configuration. You have already known these three configurations.